Sir, Avinash Shah has to come on the stage.
Madam, I'm actually not going to do a comedy show. I'll just walk you through some of my life experiences which you might enjoy. I actually swim in Tolly Club and there was a lady swimming with me and I asked her, what do you do? So she said, I'm an HRD manager. I said, what is HRD? She said, hum ragad denge. So I said, but what did you qualify for doing this? She said, I'm an MBA. I said, what did they teach you in MBA? He said, SWOT analysis. So I said, what does that mean? He said, strength, weaknesses, opportunity, threat. I said, arre, I've done that for my life. Strength is my wife, weakness is my neighbor's wife, opportunity is when the neighbor goes on tour, threat is when I go on tour. I was recruiting some engineers in Kharagpur for Larsen & Toubro. And I said, you know, apart from your educational qualifications, we also take people with good family background. He said, I come from a very good family. I said, what does your father do? He said, he's in the iron and steel industry. I said, does he work for a steel plant? He said, no, he irons during the day and steels in the night. You know, I'll give you life instances of a friend of mine who used to stammer and he couldn't get a job. He said, I'll go and jump in the Ganga. While he was walking, he found a church which said, wanted a salesman. He said, let me try my luck here. So he goes and presses the bell of the church. The father opens the door and he says, yes, my son. So he said, father, I'm committing suicide. So the father said, what the hell can I do? He said, father, you have put an advertisement, wanted a salesman. Now, holy man can't send this fellow away. So he gives them 10 Bibles. He said, go and sell. In 15 minutes, he comes back and said, father, more Bibles. Father said, in the last 10 years, he's not sold a single Bible. How did he manage to sell 10 Bibles? So he asked him, how do you sell the Bible? He said, father, he says, it's simple. I go to a customer and I teach to tell him, should I read the Bible? You heard the media and the news all the time. I'll give you a life instance of a man on a Harley Davidson motorcycle driving in the zoo in the US. He suddenly found a girl getting attracted to a lion in the cage. So as soon as the girl got a little closer, the lion grabbed her collar. So the man stops his motorcycle, jumps down, gives a punch on the lion's nose, and he leaves the girl. He holds the girl and brings it back to the parents, who are very excited and very obliged. And there's a journalist passing through. He said, my God, I've never seen something like this, an act of bravery, fantastic. He said, sir, what do you do and what are your political leanings? He said, I'm an army man. He said, tomorrow in the newspaper, there'll be a caption for your bravery. Next morning in the newspaper, they show, army man. He mentioned, it's on the headlines here, army man assault an East African immigrant and robbed his lunch. Well, you know, a man who was very fond of hunting, he goes to a dog shop and said, can you give me a hunting dog? So he gave him a black Labrador. He said, what's the name of the dog? He said, salesman. He said, the name of the dog is salesman. He said, yes, sir, you go and see his performance. So as soon as he pointed the gun to a bird, before the bird could fall down, the dog jumped, ran in, and caught hold of the bird and brought him back. He was very fascinated. He said, next year when I come, give me the same dog. He said, okay, sir. So next year when he came, he gave him a brown dog. He said, no, give me the same dog. He said, no, it's useless, sir. He said, I'm damn it, I'm paying for it, so give me what I want. So he took this other dog, he shot the bird, he walked up, picked up the bird, the dog didn't budge an inch. So very disgusted, he came back to the dog shop and said, this fellow is useless. He said, we told you, sir. He said, what's happened to him? Sir, he's become sales manager now. Now, you wouldn't believe me, but I'm being honest, you're all friends here. 41 years ago, I fell in love with a girl who was a Marwari girl, and at that time, a Marwari girl can't get married to a non-Marwari. I managed to run away and get married to her, and believe me, this is a true story. Her grandfather said, I'll shoot him. I actually survived because he had a bad aim. But before that, I actually wrote a letter to my wife. I thought I might win them over like this. So I wrote, I said, "Dear Manjari, most worthy of admiration, after long consideration and much meditation, you possess in the nation my great inclination to become your relation. On this approbation of this declaration, I shall make preparation to remove my situation to a more convenient station. And by admiration of the world's multiplication, though of great variation and respective signification, I am without hesitation yours, Avinash Desmulation." I thought I won her over by my verbosity and my English. But believe me, ladies and gentlemen, she replied and she retorted back. She said, "Dear Avinash, I read your oration with much deliberation on the great infatuation on to show such variation on so slight a foundation. But after examination of a serious consideration, I suppose your animation was the fruit of recreation, which has displayed from an education. Now, without disputation, your laborious application is so tedious an occupation which deserves commendation. I am without hesitation yours and moderation." And the last but not the least, sir, a person flying in an aircraft, he suddenly has a heart attack. And they take him to a missionary hospital. And they do a bypass for him. So when he's recovering, the nun is sitting there and saying, "Do you have a medical insurance?" He said, "No." "Do you have any money?" He said, "Not at all." He said, "Do you have a relative who has money?" He said, "I just got one sister who's a spinster and she's a nun." So the nun said, "No, no, spinsters are not nuns. They are married to God." I said, "That's all the problem. Take it for my brother-in-law. Thank you very much."